Fancy meeting you here. Who is this? I have my own pass. So official.
Boom. We are here in Austin, Texas. This is my brother from another mother.
There's a guilty man.
Oh my god! Okay. So, we are in day two of Austin Film Festival. Day one was great. I ran into Jan Austin Scott's daughter from UCC. She was at Welcoming Remarks. Went to a seminar on crowdfunding by Seed and Spark, which was amazing. Such a great seminar. Really looking forward to learning more about the educational tools that they have for crowdfunding. Hey! And so heading back after just a nice Chipotle buy one get one free lunch, courtesy of Austin Film Festival. Looking forward to the rest of the festival. We'll see what happens. Awesome. Met some great people so far. Really excited about what's to come. And we're only in day two. Two more to go. Awesome. Alright, we're into day three. Quick recap of day two. I went to four panels. First one was a pitch session, not my own, and I got to watch some of those pitches, take some notes on them, mine coming up right now. And then I went to a really great crowdfunding seminar hosted by Seed and Spark. Their founder and CEO, Emily Best, was amazing. She's my favorite person. And then the third seminar I went to was a sexy seminar between the page sheets for how to write sex scenes and chemistry. You know, surprisingly not that sexy. I was a bit disappointed. So the page sheets, whatever it was called, about writing sex scenes and chemistry and all that jazz that I thought would be applicable since I write romance a lot, but was not as helpful as I was hoping it would be. But it's all good. And then also after that, I went to this phenomenal seminar on how to represent others responsibly. And so basically telling stories in front of and behind the camera and on the page that allows for inclusion, which was really awesome. That was really great. Emily Best, who's the CEO and founder of Seed and Spark, was the moderator, and she was phenomenal. And we had some great people. There was a writer from This Is Us, which was super cool because I'm such a big fan. The writer of Moana was on there. She's awesome, hilarious individual. And then also some other writers, the writers of Girl Trip. And then Kian Wayans, who is famous and has a whole bunch of famous siblings. So they were great. Woke up bright and early for a seminar about Heroes Want. Now that was a phenomenal presentation. It's going to be in my top three right now, along with the crowdfunding and the representation one. But that was amazing because we talked about Heroes Want in a very simple way. Like, as screenwriters, we are told about desire and want, but something about how John August, I believe his name, who does the podcast Script Notes, something about how he presented it made it so clear and easy and simple and gave me ideas for my own protagonist, because sometimes we as writers even struggle with something as simple as that, but it was great. Highly recommend it. And then after that, went to a seminar called Hashtag Screenwriters, which was hilarious. It was really cool because there was writers from The Good Place and Broad City and one of the great rom-coms of the modern era, Man Up, the writer of that wonderful British writer. She was hilarious as well, but it was a hilarious conversation, but I didn't think it really provided me with a lot of applicable things for me It was very much more comedy writer oriented, but it was still a fun conversation to listen in on. So the most recent seminar that I went to was about how to tell stories that really, again, about the inclusion theme, taking from another angle of how can we write stories that provoke change and in how we think in our culture. And so it was a little more specific, which also is in my top three, even though there's now four in that top three, top four, but it was really great. And one of the writers, one of the filmmakers, Effie, was phenomenal, and really liked her energy and what she was saying, and overall just really great. And so right now I'm on a quest to find Arlo's food truck before my next session, which is the pitch session, which I'm super nervous about. Practice my pitch, wish me luck. So I did not win the finalist spot for my pitch fest, but I did learn a lot. I got a lot of great feedback, especially from Miss Writer, one of the writers of Moana, which was awesome. She's so cool, I got to gush over her and how awesome Moana is. But great experience, glad I did it. Put myself out there, other people seemed to really like it too. Made some new friends, which was awesome. So pitch session was good. Then I went to a session on crafting character, which was okay. Only got a few nuggets out of it, but it was okay. But yeah, so now I'm finally on my way back to Arlo's to get my special vegan food, which I'm really excited about. Okay, I'll let you know how it goes.
So it is now final day, day four. Last night was super fun, a lot of fun. So last I left off, I showed a video of Arlo's burger, the first burger from Arlo's that I ate. That was really good. And then I ended up running into a couple folks from the festival too. And ended up chatting with them, made new friends. And then we went to the pitch party finale together, which was pretty cool, a lot of great pitches. Kind of surprised at the winners. I really thought that the two from my session that did win were gonna be in the top three. They were that good, but they were honorable mentions, so that's something. But yeah, so it was really cool to hear all the pitches, and then Jovan, my new best friend, he found me at the end of it, hung out for a little bit before we decided to go back to Arlo's and get more food. And so I tried their street tacos, so we got our food and walked literally like two steps down the street to Stubbs Barbecue. I ended up getting sweet potato mash and mac and cheese that were amazing, super good. And so then we were walking and eating, back to the hotel. We're gonna go catch a shuttle to go to the Long Center for the final Heart of Film conference party. Mingled some more, had a good time, finally ran into Naomi again. Shout out to Naomi, hey. And so overall the party was pretty cool in terms of being able to chat and talk with some new people. But yeah, so it's gonna be a great day. Just two more sessions and then I have to cut out because my flight is at 6 this afternoon. So unfortunately I can't stay for all of the sessions, but it's been a great weekend overall and I'm excited to finish off this day.
I didn't see your head.
There's mom.
I went back inside.
Awkward. Mom went back inside. Awkward. Okay, bye.
Hey there. So I'm officially back in Boston and ready to go to sleep. It's 1:30 in the morning. Had a late flight come in, but feeling really great about this weekend and my time at Austin Film Festival. Today I went to a panel on women in the room, so female writers working in the industry and what that's like, what challenges that we face and how to overcome them or how to, you know, make them less challenging. Of course, the topic of sexual harassment in the industry was, of course, pivotal to the conversation, especially with everything going on with Harvey Weinstein. So very topical and still super important to discuss. But overall, it's just really inspiring to hear these women speak who have gone on to write Moana and the new Bumblebee movie from Transformers and work on This Is Us, like all these great movies and TV shows that these like awesome women are, you know, taking by storm. And it was so great to hear them talk about their experiences. And basically, the takeaway is that, you know, we deserve to be there just like anybody else. We as women have just as much of a voice and deserve to be heard and can write whatever we want to write and shouldn't be, you know, penalized just for our gender. And it was so great. And, you know, they didn't have any recordings or pictures going on because they wanted to be really frank, and I loved that about it. And super happy I got to go into it. It was packed. They were turning people away, so it was really great that I got to sit in on that. And then after that, I went to a conversation with Dan Gilroy, who is the writer-director of the film Nightcrawler and the new Denzel Washington movie. I forget, something Esquire. But I went with my friend Jovan because he was excited to go to that. I wasn't really sure what I was going to go into it and what was I going to get out of it. But it ended up being really great because he's a writer-director, which is what I want to do. And so there was actually some great takeaways, you know, hope to apply to my own writing and my own, you know, experience as a director. And then after that, I networked some more, otherwise known as hanging out with some of my new friends, which is so great to say because they really are some new friends of mine, especially Jovan, Naomi, and, you know, the great people I met there. So overall, it was a great experience. I can't wait to go back next year, but also just really inspired to, you know, tell the stories that I want to tell. It gave me a lot of things to think about in terms of how to plan out the next steps of my career. So overall, it was a great experience, and I love that I got to go back to Austin, my favorite city. So thank you, BU and Calm, for allowing me to do this. I feel like it was worth every penny, and I really hope that other students can take advantage of opportunities like this. All right, I'm going to sleep now.